determine the change in any chemical. Okay, I think we completed the word equation, isn't it?
Yes, sir. We started with chemical equation.
Yes. You have to start with chemical.
You told me to write that chemical equation is basically a mathematical way to represent
any chemical change.
Very good. Then reversible sign, and also you told irreversible cosine, then product reactant.
Okay. So, beta, today, let's suppose we have to, today we are going to discuss the balancing of a chemical reaction.
Yes, sir.
Balancing of any chemical reaction. Firstly, beta, we want to know why the balancing is very important. So, can you guess, Anjana, why balancing is very important?
So maybe like we want this one kind of a law, like if when you're making, not law, basically a theory, like when you're making both the reactant products, reactants should be equal to the product or something like that.
You are right, and this is a law. Actually, you are yes, you're a bit confident about yourself, beta. You're right, and you are actually right. This is a law. The law is mass conservation. The mass of reactant is equal to the mass of the product. Okay.
Yes.
Let's suppose we are reacting two substances A and B, and there is a formation of C. Then the mass of A plus B is equal to the mass of C. So why the balancing of chemical reaction is very important, beta? To follow law of mass conservation. Okay, let's suppose, beta, we have given an equation that is twice Mg plus O2 is equal to twice of MgO. Okay. Is this reaction balanced, beta? Can you check this reaction?
2mg plus O2. 2mg. No, sir. I think because in the first one over here, there's only one oxygen atom. But in the second one over here, there's two oxygen atoms.
Beta, if you write the element which is present over here, that is Mg and O.
Yes, sir.
It is L side, that is the left side, and it is R side. Mg, there is 2mg, and O, if you talk about O, there are 2O, that is O2, that means 2O. In the same way, beta, if you talk about R means product side, okay, Mg multiplied by 2, that is 2mg, and O is multiplied by, of course, 2 beta, so it is 2. Now we can say that the reaction is balanced. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first is your mass conservation. And second atom is also conserved, because here is two atom of magnesium is equal to the two atom of magnesium. So second is atom.
Yes, sir.
Atom conservation.
Atom conservation.
Okay. For the following two reasons, beta, for the following two reasons, the balancing is very important. So sometimes question may be asked in a board exam why the balancing is very important. So you have to write for the following of mass conservation and the following up of atom conservation, the balance
atom conservation. Is important.
Okay. I am giving equation to you. Again, I am giving equation that is H2 plus O2 is equal to H2O. Okay. Tell me this, either this reaction is balanced or not?
So here there are two. I don't think it's balanced, because in the next side it's only 1O, right, sir?
Left side. I think beta, you should write in your notebook and then do. Then it is good.
Yes,
good for us.
So in the right hand side, only oxygen, only one atom is there.
Yes, very good. And left hand side, there is a two atom of oxygen.
So atom. Yes.
Oxygen is deficient. So we can say it is an unbalanced equation. That means it is not following the law of chemical, the law of mass conservation as well as the law of atom conservation. Isn't it, beta?
Yes, sir.
So any given equation, which is either balanced or not balanced, let's suppose this equation is given. Okay, and you have to check and or we can say you are checking this reaction is either balanced or not. You have to check.
Yes,
I'm understanding. You are understanding my words?
Yes, I have to check, sir.
आपको चेक करना है इधर ये बैलेंस है या बैलेंस नहीं है. सो एनी गिवन इक्वेशन इधर बैलेंस्ड or not balanced is known as Skeleton equation.
Yes, sir.
Any given equation, beta, which is either balanced or not balanced, is known as skeletal equation. So sometimes, beta, there may be question, what is skeletal equation? Any equation which is given is known as skeletal equation. Let's suppose we are having equation like Fe plus H2O. It is Fe3O4 plus H2. Tell me, beta, this reaction is balanced or unbalanced? It is a skeletal equation.
Fe, there's only one. Then H2, there are two O. So you have three Fe's are there. O is four. H plus H2. So it is not balanced because the Fe, the iron atom, is only one in the left hand side. But whereas in the right hand side, it is three. And okay. The oxygen also is only one in the left hand side, and the right hand side it's four.
Okay, generally in exam we have to write like this, okay, because exam wants some representation, beta. So it is, yes, it is R, it is one, here it is three, it is two, it is one, it is four, because beta, all the atoms are not equal to right hand side or left hand side. So we can say this is the unbalanced equation.
Yes, sir. We can say that it's unbalanced equation.
So if you have to balance it. For balancing, beta, what we have to do, we have to multiply by some things. Like here is three atom of Fe. So we have to multiply by three, like three Fe plus H.
Yes, sir.
It make Fe3O4. H2, beta. Is any problem?
So how will it be O? How is it changing to 4 over there then, sir?
Okay. Let me write, beta.
Yes, sir.
Now you got the Fe3 is equal to Fe3?
Yes, sir. Fe3 we got.
Okay. Now we are having 4 oxygen. Now we are having,
yes, sir,
oxygen here. And in left side, we are having H2O. So we have to multiply the 4 into coefficient part. This is the wrong way to write 4 into 2. That is the wrong way, or we can write also that is 2 into 4. That is also the wrong way. Because this way, beta, the formula of water is getting changed. Okay. So we multiply in the coefficient part. Now 4 oxygen atom we got. But now the hydrogen atom is 8. Now the hydrogen atom is 8 and here hydrogen atom is only 2. So we have to multiply it by 4. By the way, we got 4H2.
Yes, sir, 4H2.
Getting or not?
Yes, sir, getting it, sir.
If we check now this reaction, Fe, H and O beta, it is 3. It is 3 here. H is 8, 4 to the 8, and here 4 to the 8. O is 4, 1 to 4, and here 4. So now we can say that all the atoms are balanced. That may atom conservation is 100% is being followed. That may this reaction is. Okay.
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
The next thing, beta, if your reaction is balanced, so you have to make. You have to make. Your reaction. Your reaction more informative. More informative. How we can, you can arrange how you can write the information in the reaction, beta. That means, beta, you can write its states of the material, that is states of end product. First thing. Next is if gas, if there is a gas, you can write upward arrow. If there is PPT, you can write downward arrow. Okay, beta, if there is a color change, so you write the color of that particular compound. Okay, beta?
Okay, yes, sir.
So let me write one thing, beta, your Fe, iron, you know, Fe is a metal, so we can put solid state, that is metal is a solid, solid by nature.
Yes, sir.
But you should know one thing, beta, that iron is always reacts with steam. So it is always react with steam, and steam is gas by nature. So you have G for gas. Fe3O4 is solid and H2 is a gas. Okay. So this is the way which we can write the equation, and H2 is a gas. So we can put the upward arrow here.
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Is any doubt, beta?
No, sir.
Okay.
Can I just write this down? I'll just write this down. Just a minute, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
This is your skeletal equation. You have to either this reaction is balanced or not.
Yes, sir. Here it's 1, 1, then N over is 2, then here also is, wait, here it's 1, it's, then here O is 3, over there it's 2, wait, 4. By NO, we are saying nitrogen and oxygen, right, sir? Just to confirm.
NO2.
Yes, sir.
NO2 is nitrogen
Nitroxide.
dioxide, but a nitrogen dioxide.
Yes, sir. Nitrogen.
Yes.
So here, what is this four over here? Okay. So it's not balanced.
हाँ यस इट्स नॉट बैलेंस सो
I need
क्या
to balance it.
हाँ यू शुड ट्राई एटलीस्ट वन टाइम
Yes, I'll try. I'm not getting this one.
Firstly बेटा आई थिंक यू गॉट दिस दिस टाइम दैट नाइट्रोजन इज टू हेयर
Yes, sir. He is over here.
ओके
Yes,
सो
sir.
ओके सो यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय टू फर्स्टली
Okay. Yes, sir.
वन थिंग बेटा आई एम सजेस्टिंग फॉर व्हेन वी बैलेंस एनी इक्वेशन व्हेन एवर यू आर हैविंग ऑक्सीजन इन अ ऑड नंबर सो कैन यू सी हियर द ऑक्सीजन इज फाउंड इन अ ऑड नंबर दैट इज
Yes, it's found in five.
फोर एंड फाइव सो यू हैव टू मेक
Yes, sir.
अ इवन नंबर दैट इज वेरी कॉमन थिंग यू शुड डू सो यू कैन मेक इट इवन सो नाउ इट बिकम इवन नंबर
Yes, sir.
ओके सेकेंड स्टेप बिकॉज बेटा नाउ पीबी इज टू एंड पीबी इज वन ऑन हेयर सो यू कैन राइट ट्वाइस पीबी एनओ थ्री होल ट्वाइस इट मेक्स ट्वाइस पीबीओ प्लस एनओ टू प्लस ओ टू इजेंट इट
Yes, sir.
ओके नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एन एन इज टू एंड टू टू द फोर सो नाइट्रोजन इज फोर ओवर हेयर सो वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय फोर हेयर इजेंट इट
Yes, sir.
इफ यू राइट और द फाइनल बैलेंस्ड इक्वेशन यू आर हैविंग पीबी यू आर हैविंग नाइट्रोजन एंड यू आर हैविंग ऑक्सीजन लेड इज टू सो लेड इज टू इन बोथ साइड नाइट्रोजन
Yes, sir.
टू टू द फोर फोर ऑक्सीजन इज थ्री टू जा सिक्स टू जा ट्वेल्व एंड हेयर टू इन पीबीओ एट इन एनओ टू एंड टू इन ओ टू दैट्स मेक्स ट्वेल्व ऑल्सो सो फाइनली वी कैन से दैट योर रिएक्शन इज बैलेंस्ड
Yes, sir.
इज एनी प्रॉब्लम बेटा
No, sir. No, sir.
बेटा वन थिंग यू हैव टू लर्न एनओ टू गैस इज रेड ब्राउन कलर बाय नेचर
Yes, sir.
इट इज हैविंग रेड ब्राउन फ्यूम्स
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
अगेन आई एम गिविंग द थर्ड थर्ड क्वेश्चन टू यू चेक बेटा दिस रिएक्शन इज बैलेंस और नॉट इफ नॉट देन बैलेंस
Yes, sir. So it is a balanced equation.
Yes, it is a balanced equation. Okay. Okay. Again, I am giving fourth one, N2 plus H2 is equal to NH3.
Yes.
Check whether this is balanced or not.
Yes, sir. So it is not balanced.
Then balance. If not balanced, then balance better.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes. So can I make it N2 plus H6 is then equal to 2 and H3?
Beta, I think you did the same mistake why what I told to you. I
can't change the downward.
I told to you, beta, whenever you have to multiply by H2, you have to multiply in its coefficient part. If you multiply in this part, then your formula is getting changed. You made hydrogen.
Yes,
you researched a new formula of hydrogen today. Okay, so that is the correct way. That is the correct way. Okay, next. And try this.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Peter, got it?
Yes, sir, got it, sir. I'm getting the answer as BaCl2 plus Na2SO4 gives BaSO4 2NaCl.
Very good, very good. And one thing, beta, after writing the equation, you should write it is aqueous. You know what is aqueous?
No, sir. What is aqueous mean?
Aqueous means something moist that is added with water. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
And NaCl, you can write it as always aqueous or solid, whatever you can write.
Yes, sir.
6-1.
This gives us So I'm getting the balancing as 2AlCl3 plus 3ZnSO4 gives us Al2SO4 outside 3 plus 3ZnCl2.
Okay.
That's what I'm getting.
Can you write here?
Yes, I can.
Can you write here?
Yes, sir. I like that. 2A. Sorry, this means it's no. 2AlCl3 plus what did I write? 3Zn. ZnSO4 gives us what is Al2 in bracket what is again SO4 only SO4 plus 3Zn. Yes, sir.
Good.
Okay, I got
the math. Okay, good. I think you got fully how the balanced chemical equation is done, okay?
Yes, sir.
Last question I am giving to you, then I will give an assignment. That is FeSO4 gives Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. This is the last question.
Yes, sir.
Yes, beta?
Just a minute, I'm just doing it, sir. Just a minute.
Okay.
So, 2FE, 2S, okay, that will be so. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, should I write it down again?
Hi. No. Just tell me. I will write it.
So, 2FeSO4.
Okay.
That gives us the same equation. No changes in that one.
Okay. Then it is correct. But one thing you write, beta, FeSO4 is solid. Fe2O3 is solid. SO2 is gas. SO3 is gas. And FeSO4 having green by nature. It is green color. It has green color actually. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So you should write it.
Just a minute, I'm just writing it.
Okay.
Yes, it is, sir.
Okay. Then, but today we did the generally equation part, balancing part. Now we will do the ionic equation balancing.
Yes, sir.
Ionic equation balancing. Beta, what is the ionic equation? Ionic equations mean those equations which contain ion. Let's suppose zinc plus HIN gives Zn2 plus ion and H2. This is your ionic equation. So when beta we do the balancing of the ionic equation, we have to check two things. In normal equation, we have to check only one thing, that is a conservation of atom or the number of atom, that is a mass conservation. But in the ionic balancing, we have to check two things. The first is that is the number of atom as well as, and the second is charge. The second is charge. Okay, two things to check on. And one thing, beta, I'm advising to you, firstly, break this equation into its simpler way, means Zn is converting into zinc 2 plus ion. In the same way, H plus is converting into H2. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Then beta, we have to balance two things. We have to check two things, that is number of atom and charge. So here atom is same because zinc is one only, and here the zinc is one only. Atom, we have to balance the charge only. Because beta, in right side, in zinc 2 plus side, there is a 2 unit of positive charge, and in left side, there is a zero charge. That means no charge. So we have to neutralize it by adding twice of electron, because you know the charge of electron is Sanjana 2 minus, that is 1 minus 2 minus, that means 2 positive and 2 negative makes neutral. Okay. In the same way here hydrogen is 1 only and here hydrogen is 2. So we have to multiply it by 2. Okay. And beta, here 2 unit of positive charge, so we have to multiply it, we have to add on 2 electron. Okay, is it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, it's clear, sir.
Now beta, one advice to you, one very clear thing you should know about this. The number of electron in this first equation should be equal to the number of electron in the second equation. The number of electrons should be same. The number of electron should be same.
Yes.
Why they should same, beta? Why they should same? Because we are not getting the any of the electron in the product part. That means is this final equation, we doesn't need any electron. But here the half equation which we balance is full of electron, so we have to cancel out these electron, because if we add this equation, why we have to add it? But because beta, there is a plus charge between them, so on adding beta, it makes zinc plus twice of electron plus twice of H positive gives beta zinc 2 plus plus twice of electron plus H2. Okay. Now here, electron is cancelled out. We can write zinc of plus twice of HIN is equal to zinc of 2 plus plus H2. Okay. So,
yes,
beta, finally, we have to check the number of atom as well as the number of charge. Zinc is 1, no problem. Hydrogen is 2, no problem. Charge is 2 unit of positive because 1 into 2, and here is 2 unit of positive also. So finally, we we found such an equation in which charge and atom both get balanced, and this is your balanced chemical equation.
Okay, yes, sir.
So whenever we do ionic equation balancing, beta, we have to balance two things, that is the charge and number of atom.
Yes, sir.
You want to note it?
Yes, sir. Please, I'll just.
Okay. Yes, beta, got it?
Just a minute, just one.
Okay, okay, okay.
Yes, sir, done, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, then do this problem, beta. Al plus H two is equal to Al three plus and H two. Firstly, you have to check it, either this equation is balanced or not. If not, then balance it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, so A L over here. Yeah, it's 1, 1, which is 1 and 2. Two, so I have to make it Al plus 2H gives me Al plus H2. Yeah. So then this one is A plus 1. See? Al2s versus Al3s plus H2al is already fine. So won't it just be Al plus 2H gives us Al 3 plus H2?
You are getting beta?
So I'm getting Al plus 2H gives us Al 3 plus H2.
But beta, here the charge is not balanced. Okay. Here 2 units of positive charge, here 3 units of positive charge. Okay. In last slide, we have seen that number of atom and charge both should be balanced. Okay. So please try again.
Yes, six. So I'm not able to do it.
Okay, let's see beta. As we did last question, we have to break this question into parts, because beta, Al is converting into Al 3 plus.
Yes, sir.
And H plus is converting into H2.
H2.
As we know that we have to do two things, because Al is balanced here, we have to balance only charge. So we have to multiply, yes, to add on 3 electron, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Here 2 is multiplied and 2 electron is added. Is any problem?
No, sir.
This is equation 1 and this is equation 2.
Yes, sir.
Now, beta, we know one thing from previous one, number of electrons should be equal or same. So here is, but here is 2 electron. So this is not equal. So we have to make them equal. How we can make them equal? This is a simple mathematics. If we are multiplied by 2 here, and if we multiplied by 3 here. So 2, 3 is 6 and 3, 2 is 6, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
It will make 2Al 3 plus and 6 electron. This is equation.
Yes, sir. Again.
And here 6 electron plus 6H plus will make 3H2. This is equation.
Yes, sir. 2.
Now, if we add two things, okay? That means 2Al plus 6 electron plus 6H positive make 2Al 3 plus 6 electron plus 3H2.
Yes, sir.
The electron and electron got cancelled out. 2Al plus 6H positive makes 2Al 3 plus and 3H2. If you check the equation, here Al is 2, Al is 2, H is,
yes, sir.
6, H is 6, electron is 3, 2, just 6, 3, 2, just, sorry, proton is 3, 2, just 6, and here positive charge is 6. So whole equation, yes, is balanced now. Okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
One clue point for this question, the number of electrons would be equal. Okay?
Yes, sir. I'll just write this down. Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
This question, which is your homework actually?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you should write these questions. Na plus H positive is equal to Na plus plus H2 and Cu.
Yes, I'm just writing it down. Yes, sir. Done, sir.
Okay, so that's all for today, Sanjana. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I will send some of the questions of your textbook. You are having which textbook with you?
So I have the grade 10 CBSE textbook, and I have a Lakhbir Singh textbook.
Okay, you are having Lakhbir Singh.
Yes, sir.
I will send some of the question of Lakhbir Singh as well. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you.